Hi everyone, I'm Graham. Today I'm joined by my colleague Paolo and this rather interesting large TV, but it's actually a lot more than that, isn't it? Let me get this right, an interactive large format display.
That's correct, or ILFD as we call it for short, yes.
Right.
So what we've got here, you say, it's more than a TV. This is an interactive large format display. And it's an all-in-one interactive large format display. And what I mean by that is that included into this product is we have two 15-watt front-facing speakers, an 8-array microphone with 8-meter pickup, and then you have a 4K USB AI camera as well. So really good for video conferencing capabilities, for speaker framing, and for active speaker recognition.
So all the bits you'd usually buy to bolt on to a large panel anyway, it's all included.
Exactly right, Graham. Brilliant. It's all included in the box and ready for your video conferencing experiences. Now, this product has a lot of can have a lot of standalone features, but what we're really going to concentrate on today is the user experience around bring your own device. So users going into a meeting room with a connected device, like I'm going to demonstrate right here, putting their device onto the screen and then being able to really get the full power and the maximum power of having this on a large format device with the supporting peripherals to make it really engaging and collaborative in that meeting.
So I'm one of these people, I'm awful, I forget to book a room, I run into a room and then I'm on the screen trying to get that room to join. Exactly. So what you're saying is I just have to join from my notebook and then I connect to the panel?
Exactly that. As simple as just plugging it in with a cable, you're going to have your device up there, you're going to be able to control your device, and then most importantly, when you're going to have those video calls, you're going to be able to see the supporting peripherals that you'd be able to call straight away and have that in-room experience. And then most importantly, the people at the other end of the call are going to feel like that they are being active participants within that conversation.
So rather than the camera on my notebook, it switches to all of the hardware here, yeah?
Exactly.
Fantastic.
Yeah. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to kind of give that a quick demonstration, just show people how easy it is. What I really like about the bring your own device element is that from a user experience perspective, it feels common to them. It feels native to them. It's their device. It's their personal profile. They're logged into everything. They know where all their files are. They know what applications they want to use. So when they go into the meeting room, they can start that meeting straight away and access the information they need to do right at their fingertips.
So no ramp up, no learning curve. It's all about driving it from there.
Exactly. And I think the most important thing is trying not to create what I call meeting room islands. So you don't want to create these silos of meeting room technology or experiences which are just dedicated to the meeting room, because then users are not familiar with how to utilize it. They won't be able to maximize their interactions with that. But then subsequently, when they leave the meeting room and they need to carry on that work or carry on those conversations, what tools are we providing them to do that? So actually, if we pivot back to the mainstay of the way they work, which is on their own devices, and just maximize the way they utilize that in a meeting environment, I think the users are going to have a much better experience for
it. Very much so, yeah.
So I'm just going to show this straight away. I've got my personal device here. I'm just going to make sure I'm all logged on, and then I am going to connect this.
Okay, so just a single USB-C cable, yeah?
Single USB-C cable is the easiest way. There's different methodologies of connecting. You can have the same experience with HDMI, which will carry your audio-visual, and then a USB A to B, which will carry your data, your touch, and then see your cameras. But a USB-C, which has the display port enabled through that cable, gives you everything from the one cable. So I'm just going to connect that at the moment. You can see automatically prompts for me to switch over. And then I'm going to be immediately into my desktop and my applications. And then I'm going to have full control over those as well. So you can see here at the moment, I've just got a presentation which I've launched. I'm not only able to see this, I'm able to fully control this. And whilst it's all the time controlling my device as well. Now, the benefits of obviously being able to do that is you don't have to keep returning to your device. It's a much more engaging and inclusive experience when we are discussing with people in the room. But also importantly is tools like you have in Microsoft already with their inking features then become really optimized on the large formats. I'm going to pick up a pen. These products come with two passive styluses. I'm able to select this on my Microsoft ink, and I'm able to start to input and annotate straight in.
And that's here. Capturing it on your primary device.
Exactly, that's right. Capturing it on my primary device. It's straight into there. It's basically not doing anything fancy of overlaying. This is in, because I'm using the Microsoft tools, it's embedding that into my PowerPoint. So these are selectable objects now, or inking features within Microsoft. I can delete these and erase these. I can save it as my PowerPoint in there with my raw notes. And what we know from user experience and memory is that actually when you're looking at raw notes, it prompts you a lot more as to what that conversation was, rather than having to go and type something up. You've got the visual reference to it, and you can input that directly into the slides where you want to have that. Right. So it's a really powerful tool.
So what sizes are these available in?
So these are available in 65, 75 and 86 inch currently. And as I say, we've got that included with the camera speakers and the microphones. So the next stage is I'm working with my colleagues in the room. How about when I want to bring in people that are remote users?
Yeah.
And want to demonstrate and show what I'm doing? Well, I say it's really simple. So I'm going to launch in this scenario, I'm going to use Microsoft Teams because that's what we use. I'm going to launch this. This is really my personal profile. I'm already logged in. It has all of my chats, Teams, calendars, everything there where I can access my information. And as you can see, if I'm going to make a call, just to show you on the settings that we have the speakers, microphone configured, and we have our USB 4K camera ready there to start capturing that right in our call.
The mess of those cables there as well.
Yeah, you can see the light in the cable. But we are ready there, so then when I dial that in for my remote participants, they're going to see me interact with my screen, and they're going to have that experience as if they were in the room with us as well. Now, it's not one of the most unique things with Bring Your Own Device is that it's agnostic as well. So it's whatever platform you want to use, whatever on your device it can support. So in this example, I can then go into my Zoom account and again, show a very similar experience. So I'm going to select the video, and there my camera is ready for us to start getting on that video call straight away.
Fantastic.
Exactly. So we're there. It's a very easy user experience. I say for me, it's about maximizing the applications which users use outside the meeting room. They're going to want to go into the meeting room and use those same applications. So even tools such as Microsoft Whiteboard, we often use it in the calls as well. Just to show you an example, we can launch a whiteboard session. And now I can send this to active participants and we can start to collaborate and input together. And I'll show you how that is being triggered via a Microsoft Teams call as well.
Brilliant. So these are out now?
These are available now. There is stock available with our distribution channel. So for any inquiries, please contact your Lenovo account manager and please reach out to ourselves as well.
And don't forget, if you like what you saw, hit like, subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos. Thank you, Paolo.
Thank you, Graham. Take care.
Thank you very much.